discussion meeting actually with the stakeholders for choosing the right management of staff. We know severe acute malnutrition is an issue in Bangladesh. And in this meeting, I want to welcome all of you from different areas. Your expertise and contribution, particularly in the improvement of nutrition in Bangladesh, we consider it quite valuable. Today, with us, I want to welcome Professor M.R. Khan, who will be available here very soon. And I also want to welcome Dr. Makhdoomah Nargis, who is the Additional Secretary and Project Director, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. And also Dr. Mohammad Alamgir Ahmed, is Director, Institute of Public Health, Nutrition, and also Line Director of National Nutrition Services. I also want to welcome Professor Dr. Mohammad Shahidullah, President BPA, and also Professor M.P. Kue Talukdar, as well as Dr. S.K. Roy. Professor Talukdar is the advisor of BBF, and S.K. Roy is the chairperson of Board of Trustees, BBF. I also want to welcome all of you dignitaries here present, and I believe your participation in different points, particularly in discussion of today's main issue, particularly on choosing the right management of SAND. I want to thank all of the participants to be with us in this morning, and I am very sorry that we are a bit late. We are a bit late, and please help us, particularly through your contribution in the next discussions. Respected participants, I should, on behalf of BBF and on my personal behalf, I must want to thank you, because the participation here, as I find, is quite good, and a lot of you are here. I want to welcome Professor M.R. Khan, our national professor, and I believe our contribution, our deliberation, our discussion will be very helpful for the benefit of our children, particularly those who are severely here in this, those who are with severe acute malnutrition. I want to thank all of you, and finally I welcome all of you in our deliberations and contributions. Thank you.
Our distinguished chief guest, Mr. Professor M.R. Khan, distinguished colleagues, ladies and gentlemen. We have assembled here with many groups of stakeholders on infant and young child feeding and malnutrition. I have not seen very many meetings like this as we are here today. Today's meeting focuses on the use of right kind of food for the treatment of severe malnutrition in the community. Today's meeting culminated from a very disturbing international symposium that was held by ICDDRB at the beginning of this month. On 9th June, Daily Star published a front page news saying, miracle food made in Bangladesh. It is a very disturbing title. It's a false claim. And the row began with the publication of this news following the international symposium on ready-to-use therapeutic food. Ready-to-use therapeutic food cannot be a miracle food. I'm coming to that point later on. ICDDRB's research on ready-to-use therapeutic food, I knew about this, and I spoke to Tamir, discussed with him, and suggested him, even told him, that this research would not be a good start to solve the problem of severe malnutrition in the country. UNICEF funded this research for the locally made ready-to-therapeutic food. The history of ready-to-IUTF, it began about a decade ago in France. Nutriset is a commercial company who on the formulation of a scientist who worked in Bangladesh, Andrew Bryant, they produced the plant, which they called it as ready-to-use therapeutic food. So now, you see, this ready-to-use therapeutic food, it made a stunt in the management of acute, severe malnutrition. The idea was that the child should be given a food which should be pre-prepared, pre-packaged, and it should be supplied at home. Now, the RUTA contains 60% of fat, which is a very abnormal composition of any food whatsoever. The RUTF, it does not contain any water. And the RUTF contains the powder milk. And as the powder milk, we know from the World Health Assembly resolution that was taken in 2005, where they found that the powder milk is a good vehicle for the multiplication of bacteria. And no powder milk today, wherever it is produced, can be free of bacteria. No one can claim this. Even ICDDRB have found that in the infant formula, they found the microorganisms, which may be very fatal for children. It's a very unconventional food. Whereas conventional food, as it was researched in ICDDRB in 2002, Tahmeed, he was involved in this research. They used khichdi and halwa, and they found that this can be used with a mortality of less than 1% for the recovery of the severe acute malnutrition. Then why do you go for another alternative? The argument that ICDDRB and as Tahmeed is here, then you see, then why do we go for another alternative? The home-based food which is available, which the formula, the ingredients that we know, and the work was done even a decade previous to 2002 by Dr. Sultana Khanum, and she proved, it was published in the Lancet, that the home-cooked food, even when the mother is cooking this food at home, the severely malnourished children could be getting full recovery. You see, we are in a world of today where the nutrition and the management of malnutrition is now thought to be taken over by business. It's a business-based approach that the United Nations agencies, and it is the market-based approach, it is the product-based approach that we are going to have to encourage business involving the private sector, which would really mean business, is now encouraging the professionals to use a ready-to-use therapeutic food. In this country, I have been associated with the nutrition programs and have seen how the improvement has taken place. In the hospital, especially, I had an interest in treating severe acute malnutrition. We have treated it with cow's milk, and this cow's milk was given to the energy extent of on the basis of the body weight. At the same time, we encouraged the children to take any food they would like, and we found that the mortality was less than 5%. So therefore, I don't think that we should reinvent something for the country, and I consider that this research was not necessary, and this food is not necessary to be used for the management of severe malnutrition even at home. You see, if there are about 300,000 children, those who are suffering from acute malnutrition, you'll have to find them out and supply them this food. This food, the composition of such food is to the extent of 60% of fat. I'm sure there is no doubt that it will be changing the composition of the whole body. Say, for example, ektu shohajbhabe amra chinta kori je ekta bachcha jodi severe malnutrition hoy take jodi amra ekta energy dei, total energy jototuku lagbe amra bori je 110 kilocalories per kilogram body weight amra debo in divided to seta jodi amra dei ebon tar bhitre it will not be more than 25% of fat, the child will be recovering from severe malnutrition. Keno amra oi khabar ta jeta unconventional ebong je powder milk ta mishachi she powder milk er moddhe erokom jibanu thakte pare, and that is a big risk. Ebong shei joni bola hocche je ami emon ekta research product byabohar korchi jar bhitre ei powder milk byabohar korchi, tar pore jodi ami international symposium kori, and then we encourage people to take this food, tahale then you know we are violating the code, seta amra korte pari na. Ar ekta holo je ei khabar ta jokhon mader ke dewa hobe barite, tokhon the mothers will have a perception that this is the food that I need for the recovery of my child from severe malnutrition, and also perhaps I'll be giving this food from time to time so that the child does not suffer from malnutrition in future. Whole perception take badle jebe jekom perception badle dilo gura dud ওরা তো এরকম পারসেপশন মাদেরকে বদলে দিয়েছে যে একটা ডিম তারা দুই সপ্তাহ ব্যবহার করে এবং বাচ্চাকে পাতলা করে খাওয়ায়, মনে করে এটা খুব দামি খাবার, তখন বাচ্চা ম্যানুয়াল শুনে এবং বুক ঢুকতে থাকে। আর একটা হলো, যখন এই সমস্ত খাবার আমরা দেব, এই খাবারগুলো যদি মাদেরকে, মারা যদি শিশু বাচ্চাদেরকে দেয়, তখন ব্রেস্ট ফিডিং যে সে করছিল কিছু কিছু, সে ব্রেস্ট ফিডিং থেকে সে দূরে সরে যাবে, ব্রেস্ট ফিডিংটা এরকম ভাবে তখন আন্ডারমাইন্ড হয়ে যাবে। তো সুতরাং আমি সাজেস্ট করব যে দিস ইজ এ নন স্টার্টার, অ্যান্ড আই উড স্ট্রংলি সাজেস্ট দ্যাট ICT দেয়ার নিডস টু স্টপ গোয়িং ফার্দার উইথ দিস প্রোগ্রাম, অ্যান্ড আই উড অলসো সাজেস্ট দি UN এজেন্সিস দ্যাট উই শুড হ্যাভ রেসপেক্ট ফর দি ফুড বেসড অ্যাপ্রোচ ফর দি চিলড্রেন উইথ ম্যালনিউট্রিশন অফ এনি ডিগ্রি। উই শুড নট থিঙ্ক ইন দিস কান্ট্রি ইন পার্টিকুলার অ্যাবাউট দি প্রোডাক্ট বেসড অ্যাপ্রোচ। ইন ইন্ডিয়া RUTF ওয়াজ ব্যান্ড ইন 2009। ইভেন দি প্রাইম মিনিস্টার spoke that our children at home will be taking home-cooked food. And also this was passed by the